Things have changed. No, you can't do it. And you go for therapy. You try and go for sexual therapy. And that's why you go to someone like Dr. Ruth Westheimer. This is a good thing. A little tiny Jewish lady who talks about oral sex, and you know she doesn't even eat pork. Warning. This is a good sign. I'm saying if you want sexual help, you don't want a little tiny Jewish lady. You want a large black lady named Dr. Ruth. Yeah. She'll help your ass then, because she'll be goddamn honest with you. You call in and say, Dr. Ruth, I have a small penis. Does that make a difference? She'll go, damn straight, baby. Mm-mm. Honey, you can't make butter with a toothpick. You know what I'm saying? Mm-mm. Work with it, baby. Mm-mm. Don't be coming at me with that tiny puppet. Go embrace yourself. Dress it up, get some Ken and Barbie clothes, put on a show, like, make it something special, baby. Don't just do that, because most men's idea of foreplay is, ooh, here I come, Why do they say you're coming? You ain't going nowhere, you're in the same place, you know what I'm saying? And men, learn some foreplay, you know what I'm saying? Learn how to deal with women. Most men grab your titties like they're making bread, like, yeah, yeah, yeah. I say you want to make cookies, get your ass in the kitchen. You want to make love, stay here right now. Like, they're always trying to push your breasts together, make one good one, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, what the hell is that about? Mm-mm. And sometimes they grab your nipples like, ah! I say, does that get you hot? Oh, I'm on fire now, Chief Smoke, yeah! Oh, yeah! Mr. Vice Grip, Mr. Pliers, oh, yeah! I'm cooking now, baby, oh, yeah! The hell! What, and then they start doing that, start twisting your nipples! What's that supposed to do? Are you dialing a radio? The hell is this? The radio for you? Baby! Mm. Next time a man grabs you like that, you grab his testicles and go, is this a slinky? Get his ass. You know what to do then, baby. I guarantee you'll have his attention then. You squeeze those, his eyes come out. You've got your own little play puppet there. Squeeze him, yo. One squeeze for the condo, two for the Porsche. You know what I'm saying? You got his attention then, baby. You know what I'm saying. Men, learn yourself some oral sex. You know what I'm saying? I know most men, thank you, brother, thank you. Testify, because most men go, hey, I'm out of there, baby. I say, bring a lunch, stay for the day. Have yourself a time. Women know what I'm saying, and men, if you can't look at it, bring a Mr. Potato Head. Dress it up like somebody else, you know, Sigmund Freud, your Uncle Murray, anybody. Have some fun there, baby, because that's what it's about. And use some birth control, because ladies, those sperm come out of there at 500 miles an hour. And a little piece of rubber is not gonna stop it. It's like putting gauze in front of a semi and go, come on through, Use a diaphragm, because you see a diaphragm is basically just a trampoline for sperm, you know what I'm saying? Doesn't necessarily stop them, just amuses their ass for a while. Yeah, hey, hey, hey. 8.1, 8.2, you know, messes them up. And men, if the lady's not gonna wear a diaphragm, you better goddamn wear a prophylactic, you know what I'm saying? A prophylactic is necessary, and most men are going, I'm not making my penis look like a tiny bank robber, Or if you wear the ones with the reservoir tip, looks like a little Krishna, like Hare Krishna. Put that thing on, and don't get the ones with ribs. If you want ribs, go get barbecue, don't put it on there. And don't get those French ticklers, you know, the things, all the little things, the spikes. It's not a penis, it makes it look like a tiny sea anemone. Bring Jacques Cousteau into the bed. We are looking for the tiny Venus. No, get it off here. Put that thing off, baby. Just put some protection on. Because, ladies, the best birth control in the whole world is simply... Just laugh at his ass. Can't take it. They can't take that shit. Men cannot take laughter at the mighty sword. You know that. That's why it's down here, and that's why you're up here going, I love you. Don't look down there. Mm-mm. You're not meant to see what the goodies are doing. When they show a porno movie, when they're going for the close-up, it's like, beauty, beauty. It's not a pretty picture. It's like an industrial film covered in fur. It's not meant to be seen. That's why your eyes are up here. You're up here doing all this love stuff because that's what it's about. You're lucky as human beings you get to make eye contact because other animals don't. If you're an amoeba, you'd split in two and go, was it good for me? Who knows?